Shall I help?
No. Leave them to me. I will deal with them myself.
Why, you stuck-up, half-witted, scruffy-looking nerf herder!
Okay, since people are definitely interpreting this whole issue wrong from the investors' day call and conference, I'm going to read you what the shareholder said, and I'm going to read you everything that Iger said back to him. And I'll let you guys decide. Now, I'm going to tell you a lot of this screaming and shouting and ranting and raving is hyperbole, cognitive dissonance, and really not understanding how politicians work. Okay, so here we go. Shareholder, I'd like to address what I view as the elephant in the room. Over the last few years, Disney has turned from a place of magic to children to an ideological company serving the LGBTQIA plus to groom children. Over and over again, we see how your filming increasingly is promoting the woke agenda. How can you explain that you recently produced an LGBTQ plus themed musical? Disney collaborated with predators to sing with children. How can you explain to children that dozens of gay pride parades will take place in Disney parks worldwide? Are you surprised that Disney's audience has plummeted, losing subscribers? No wonder Disney's stock value is lost. As a Disney stock shareholder, would it not be beneficial for the company to drop the LGBTQ ideology? And I bet you'll win back the trust of the families in the stock market. Thank you. Iger, thank you for your question. I know you were talking more about content. You are talking about content. We pride ourselves on being accessible to all people. Our company is celebrating its 100th year. We've been telling stories from 100 years aimed at inspiring families all over the years. For generations, the stories we've told have touched people's hearts. They have been infused with the right values, For generations, the stories we've told have touched people's hearts. They've been infused with the right values, instilled today that good triumphs over evil, and tomorrow is always brighter than today. I think those stories have had a positive impact on the world, a world that always loves and needs. A world that always loves and needs great stories and great entertainment, particularly today's world. We've recently gotten criticism, just as you expressed, for what some perceive to be an agenda-driven content. I'm sensitive to that. Our primary mission needs to be entertaining and have an impact on the world. I'm serious about that. While I know we're never going to please everyone all the time, we should be sensitive to the fact that parents have different levels of comfort with the content that is delivered to their children. I want children to be able to trust the content that we're creating for their children. And we're committed to delivering age-appropriate content for family audiences while also telling stories that reflect the world around us and also to foster greater understanding of all people, blah, blah, blah. So let me explain. First off, Iger basically was backpedaling. He threw in a couple of platitudes, but he did not tell this kid to back off. The kid basically dragged him over the coals, and I guarantee you this isn't the first time Bob Iger has been lambasted for the crap of Reimagine Tomorrow, etc., etc. The fact that he was pretty battered and bruised up by the time this shareholder called in, and they ended the call-in session, question session, right after this. There are people out there misinterpreting what he said. They think he's doubled down on woke. He didn't say anything of the contrary. In fact, to the contrary, he said nothing. He said absolutely nothing, as a politician of his caliber would. Okay, so we have to look at it in the way that a PR person would. Don't say anything that would get you in trouble with either side. So he didn't, okay? I didn't expect him to say, oh, I agree with you 100%. We're going to fire all the LGBTQ employees. No, they're not, okay? They're probably going to get rid of the woke ones that are causing Disney trouble, and they have been, okay? Again, I caution all of YouTube to look at what he does, not what he says, okay? The outrage factory that started up immediately is ridiculous. All right, it's ridiculous, and people need to calm down. You know, the world is in a shitty place right now, and there's light at the end of the tunnel, and every time a guy like Iger, who's not going to say anything to get him in trouble with either side, you know, is you know, you guys are going to interpret it bad. LGBTQ people and their activist buddies are going to interpret it bad too, okay? And nobody in this situation can win, all right? And I honestly think we're to a place now in the world, and I'm looking at my friends on YouTube, and I'm looking at the nemesis we all have, these grooming bastards on the left. You want to win brownie points and win points against your opponents, and you don't care what progress has been made. Okay? This isn't about you winning and them losing. This is about Disney getting the fuck out of the hole they're in and moderating their content, which I have to say, the firings I've seen seem pretty awesome, okay? All right? It seems pretty significant when HR employees are now putting their resumes out for fear of being the next ones fired, okay? All right? But don't look at what he says. It's what he does, okay? You all need to just chillax, all right? Because trust me, the investors want their dividends. They want Disney to moderate its tone. And look, BlackRock, and its business is teetering on the edge, okay? Get woke, go broke is real. This is why the SVB bank went down. Okay, this is why Signature Bank went down. This is why Deutsche Bank is in trouble, okay? This is why Credit Suisse is in trouble, all right? They can't afford it anymore. Disney is getting the shit kicked out of it by both sides, and all because they want to win brownie points, like I said, against each other. Look, the tone will moderate because it's the right business strategy. Do I want to see, you know, Shelley has two mommies? No, I don't. Okay, there should be specific programming that when a parent sees that, can say, no, we're not watching it. Okay, all right, that, and I think that's fair. Okay, I do, I think that's fair. However, I really look at what Iger said to this investor as being a mea culpa, okay? But considering that the people complaining about it didn't listen, I did. All right, I did listen. And it was a brutal, brutal event all the way around, okay? So again, remember what I said. It is not what he says, it's what he does that matters, okay? And these 7,000 layoffs are going to be mostly woke people. So don't worry about this stuff. And really, just relax. Calm down, okay? All right, just listen to what I'm saying and just sit back, because he's listening to people. This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.